Flink 2.0 is finally here. And let me tell you, it was worth the wait. After almost 9 years since release of Flink 1.0, we now have a major new release. It took over 2 years, 165 contributors, and 25 flips to get here. All right, you might be thinking, why am I standing in front of the waterfall? Well, just think about this. Kafka is like a river. It's steady. It's a never-ending stream of events flowing through your system. But Flink is a waterfall. This is where magic happens. This is where raw streams hit transformation, enrichment, aggregation, turning water into insights. Every drop is processed, reshaped, and redirected. And all this happens in the real time, just like this. So why 2.0? Why this is a big deal? Well, real-time processing has become the norm. Everyone wants the low latency event-driven system these days. But Flink 1.x real-time jobs were kind of expensive and a bit tricky to operate and build. Flink 2.0 fixes that. It built for cloud-native deployments, data lakehouses, and even for AI workloads. And the goal to make stream processing cheaper, easier, and more powerful. One of the biggest changes in Flink 2.0 is disaggregated state. Well, it sounds fancy, but what it actually means, Flink separates compute from the state storage. Instead of saving everything to local disk, it can now store it remotely in the cloud storage like S3 or HDFS. Even better, it uses asynchronous state access, so Flink can read and write state in parallel without blocking processing. Well, this is actually very huge for deployments on Kubernetes, and it makes Flink much more cloud native and cloud friendly. But what it actually means for a performance? Flink 2.0 crushed it in the benchmarks. With just 1 gigabyte of cache, you got up to 120% throughput increase comparing to Flink 1.20. Even with no cache, it still hits 50% higher throughput. This is super impressive for new architecture using remote state. And this is just the beginning. More operators are being optimized to use asynchronous state, so performance will keep improving. Next up, materialized tables. This is the Flink way of letting you treat streams and batch jobs the same. You can manage both with one table abstraction. If you need to add more columns or change a query, now you don't need to process everything. This is production-ready feature and integrates with tools like Apache Pyman for real-time data lakehouse use cases. Batch jobs also got some love. Flink 2.0 brings adaptive batch execution, such as automatically switching to broadcast joins instead of hash joins when it's possible, and better handling of skewed data. The result? Batch jobs run faster, especially in the bigger, larger data sets. In the benchmark, Flink shows increase the performance between 8 to 16%. Now, this is cool. Flink 2.0 brings support of AI models right into the stream processing pipelines. With Flink CDC 3.3, you now can run models like GPT on your events as they come in. So think about real-time fraud detection and personalized recommendations on the fly. And soon, you will be able to call the models directly from Flink SQL. I don't know about you, but my mind is blown. Now, for my developer folks, let's talk about how those changes are affecting them. Some old stuff is gone. Dataset API, old source and syncs API are gone, and my personal favorite, Scala DataStream API, also gone forever. Java 11 is minimum now, and some connectors has to be updated to use new APIs. Java 17 and Java 21 also support it. You also might need to migrate your save points since state format changed. But don't worry, there are some tools to help you. And that is Apache Flink in a nutshell. It's a new architecture, better performance, unified API, and AI readiness. Everything built for modern era of cloud deployments. So get this today, download this from the flink.apache.org, join the community, and I will see you in the streams. My name is Victor Gamov, and as always, have a nice day.